Good morning, Tigers, and welcome back to the world's greatest elementary school. We are so excited because for the first time in the last several weeks, we have a full regular week of school this week. Besides being a full week, this week is also very special because it is National School Counselor Appreciation Week, and Tigers, we have the world's greatest school counselor, Mrs. Person. On behalf of our whole Shadow Lake community, I want to express our appreciation for Mrs. Person for all she does for our Tigers, families, and staff. We hope that if you see Mrs. Person this week, you show your appreciation to her as well. Take a look at this quick video.
Thank you, Mrs. Person. We love you.
You're awesome. Woohoo!
Thank you for making a better community and a better school for us.
Thank you, Ms. Person, for helping us to be kind to each other.
Thank you for always helping our school and making it a better community.
Hi, Melanie. You are fabulous. We just love you here at Shadow Lake. Thank you for all you do for the kids and us, too.
Thank you for whenever we feel sad, being there and helping us.
We just want to thank our Mrs. Person, Miss Melanie, for all the hard work she does and for helping you kiddos out all the time. She loves you and we love her.
Thank you for always being here for everyone, no matter what they look like or just being there for everyone.
Thank you, Mrs. Person, for all you do.
Tigers, the Tahoma School District Board of Directors are coming to Shadow Lake today to see our amazing Tigers at work. The school board is a group of adults who are elected and they help make decisions that impact every one of our Tahoma schools and each of our students. We have a poster in the lunchroom that we are asking every Tiger to sign to help welcome our school board to Shadow Lake.
Yes, please make sure you sign your name. Last Wednesday, our January Students of the Month were given their certificates for showing their trait of being effective communicators. Congratulations to all of our Students of the Month. Their pictures will be posted on the Student of the Month display board in the 500 hallway leading to the Commons. Here are our January Students of the Month.
Congratulations to all of those Students of the Month. Now, Tigers, in honor of Valentine's Day and Friendship Day on February 14th, PTA is selling candy grams that you can have delivered to another student or a Shadow Lake staff member. Today, Wednesday, and this Friday, our PTA is going to be selling those at lunch recess. Each candy gram is 50 cents. You'll need to know the first and last name of the student you're sending it to, or you also need to know the staff member who you're sending it to, and then PTA will deliver those candy grams prior to February 14th so your teacher can distribute those on the 14th.
Awesome. All right, we are so excited to have Lunch Bunches and Recess Club back happening this week. Today there will be Lunch Bunch for 1st, 3rd, and 5th grade. On Wednesday, there'll be Lunch Bunch for kindergarten, 2nd, and 4th. And then there'll be recess clubs at all lunch recesses for all grades on Tuesday and Thursday. All right, Mr. Abbey, what's on the menu this week?
Oh, I'm so excited. Lunch Bunches and Recess Club are back. All right, here is this week's lunch menu. Today is mozzarella breadsticks. Tomorrow, we're going to be having chicken nuggets. Wednesday is Belgian waffle. Thursday is super nachos. And then Friday is pizza. And then Tigers, our Tiger TV video production 0 hour crew, is back with another joke of the week. Take a look.
Good morning, Tigers. Welcome to the joke of the week. Here we go. Ready? Why did the cookie go to the doctor? He was feeling crummy.
Okay, Tigers. It's time to recognize more of our amazing Tigers who have been earning Tiger Paw tickets and were selected in this week's drawing. For kindergarten, we have Maddox in Mrs. Stamp's class, Luke in Mrs. Hurley's class, Isai in Mrs. Belmondo's class, and David in Mrs. K's class. Nice job.
All right, moving on to first grade. William, congratulations, you won in Mrs. Roberts' room. Alex, you're selected in Mrs. Hansen's class. Jerome, you're the winner in Mrs. Yassine's room. Jackson, you're the winner in Mrs. Clush's class. And then Dominic, you're the winner in Mrs. Nelson's room.
Nice job. All right, moving on to second grade. We have Julia in Mrs. Kortenkamp's class. Mazer in Mrs. Kemp's room, Locke in Mrs. Shireman's room, and Florence in Mrs. Meek's class.
Way to go, second graders. Moving on to third grade. Philip, you're the winner in Mrs. Boyle's class. Abigail, you're the winner in Mr. McMaster's room. Charlie, you won in Ms. McAllen's class. And then Anna, you're the winner in Ms. Mazzatelli's room.
Awesome. For fourth grade, our winners are Hadley in Mrs. Bradley's class, Juan in Mrs. Moffitt's room, and Evelyn in Mrs. Isley's class.
And last but not least, fifth grade! Madison, you're the winner in Mr. K's room. Emerson, you won in Mrs. Lish's, and then Madeline, you're the winner in Mrs. McCutcheon's room.
All right, winners, when it is convenient for your teachers, they can send you to the office to pick up your prize from the Tiger Paw Treasure Chest. All right, Mr. Abbey, what's going on with story time today?
All right, it is Black History Month, so today, for story time, Mrs. Smith is going to be reading the book called I Am Ruby Bridges.
All right, Tigers, we hope you all have a great week, and remember,
it's a great day to be a tiger.
Hey, Tigers, welcome back to Story Time. I'm Mrs. Smith, super excited to read another story. So this month we are honoring Black History Month, and so I've decided to read one of my new books that I'm just putting into the library. This is called I Am Ruby Bridges, and many of you have probably heard of the name Ruby Bridges and a little bit of her backstory, but this is actually written by Ruby Bridges, so it's pretty cool. This is directly coming from her, and she's still alive. She's probably in her late 60s, and she's still a big advocate for civil rights and equal rights. So at the very beginning, it kind of has this little intro like a dictionary would. So it gives you ruby. What's the definition? It says a jewel, a precious stone that is red. Bridges, plural of bridge. One definition is a structure carrying a pathway or roadway over an obstacle. And then the second definition, a time, place, or means of connection or transition. Pretty interesting. And that was her name, Ruby Bridges. All right. I Am Ruby Bridges, written by Ruby Bridges. And it starts out with, I am Ruby Bridges. When I grow up, my work will be precious. I will be a bridge. I will bridge the gap between black and white, and hopefully between all people. I suppose some things in life are just meant to be. 1960. Before I started school, I wasn't thinking about who I would be when I grew up. What I was thinking about was how much I didn't even like my name. I thought Ruby was a name for a little old lady. It was much too old for someone my age. After all, I was only just turning 6. I'm told my grandmother chose my name, Ruby, chose this name Ruby for me. Well, that explains it. No wonder it's such an ancient name. But I so loved my grandmother. I thought I'll just have to live with it and try to grow into it. Surely I didn't want to hurt her feelings. So there I was, almost 6, born in 1954. I'm told that was a very important year because of the landmark case, Brown versus Board of Education. That was when the court banned segregation in schools. But all I knew that was my old name was Ruby Bridges. Oh boy, what's next? What a way to start school. Oh, well, how bad can it be, I thought. It's not like I'll be the first Ruby in the world, just the youngest. So off to school I go. It is a regular school with lots of other kids to play with. I make new best friends. Even my teacher is nice, and it's not hard at all. Surprisingly, it's easier than I thought it would be. I get lots of gold stars every day. Life couldn't get better. Then, just as things are going really well for me, surprise! I find out my parents have decided I am switching schools. To a better school, they say, with better opportunities. But first, I must take a test to get in. What are the opportunities anyways, I thought, and why do I need them, especially if a test comes with them? But then I thought, I'm ready. I'm already getting gold stars, so how hard can it be? Besides, there's no turning back now. It's what my parents want for me. Opportunities. And guess what? Another gold star. I passed the test. Can you believe it? How lucky can an almost six-year-old with an old name like Ruby be? I was about to find out because my mom said I would be starting at a brand new school the next morning and I had better behave. First day, no more walking to school with my best friends. There are four very tall men at the door to drive me to school, and they're white men. Who in the world are they? And who told them I needed a ride to school anyway? Federal marshals, they tell me, sent by the President of the United States. Federal marshals sent just for me? Wow, that must have been a very special test that I passed because they said I'm the first. The first what, I thought. I didn't find out what being the first really meant until the day I arrived at this new school. Those four very tall white men, they escort me into the building past lots of screaming white people who line the streets outside the school. It looks like Mardi Gras to me, but they aren't throwing any beads. What's Mardi Gras without beads? Once I get inside, I meet the new principal, and she is white too. I wasn't taken to my new classroom until the next day. Second day, when I arrive at my classroom, my new teacher opens the door and greets me. Hi, I'm Mrs. Henry, your teacher. Come in and take a seat, she says. And aren't I surprised, because she is also white. I had never had a white teacher before. And the biggest surprise of all, I am the only kid in the class. I didn't see any other kids at all, not one. That test must have been a lot harder than I thought. Why am I the only kid in my class? Not to mention the only kid in the whole school. And why don't I see anyone who looks like me? And then that's when it hits me. I am not just the only kid. I'm the only black person here. I thought, maybe I am the first. The first black kid in this school. So that's what they meant about being the first. Finally, it all makes sense. Me, six-year-old Ruby, the first black kid to go to this school, William France Elementary, a white school. When I asked my mom, she said, yes, it was an all-white school until the laws changed when Brown versus Board of Education won their case in the Supreme Court. Now, all black kids can go to any school they like alongside white kids. I, Ruby, being the first, helped to make that possible. And that's a good thing for Black kids, for white kids too, for all kids once they finally get here. I just want to know one thing. When are they coming? Because I know they are just like me. Who cares what colors we are? I'm just happy. Brown versus board made it right. School is just school and kids are just kids. I'm sure they'll all show up soon enough. I can't wait. I guess being six with an old name like Ruby isn't so bad after all. I suppose some things in life are meant to be. I am Ruby Bridges, the first. There we have it. And in the back, she has got an author's note here. So this is written by Ruby Bridges. And I'm not going to read the whole thing, but it says, "Here I invite the readers to journey back with me to the time when I was 5 and then 6 years old, when I didn't quite know who I was or who I wanted to be when I grew up. Most of us at that time had no idea where our names originated. I wanted to create a space for young children to read my story from the perspective of me as a child. I hope they discover I was not much different from them. I was inquisitive, creative, and inquiring, just like them. In my story, you will notice that I include a glossary, another tool to help young readers expand their vocabulary to connect their imagination to learning. Words are highlighted in ruby red. Finally, I must mention the illustrations. Oh my, they allow readers to take a colorful, lively journey with me. What a trip this will be." Written by Ruby Bridges. And when she, the other thing is up here, it says, "My goal was to captivate these curious minds while teaching them a very important moment in time in our history, a moment that changed the face of education in our country." So that is written by Ruby Bridges. I love that. I love that she was the first and she's still alive and an advocate. I think she actually works at that elementary school in that same area. So it's pretty exciting that she forged the way for equal rights. So I hope you guys enjoyed that story. Have a great week. And remember, it's a great day to be a tiger.